Mr. Lover Lover.
I remember there's a radio coming from the room next door. My mother lays some ways some ladies do.
I don't know that.
Well, it's late in the evening and the music see me through. Yeah, yeah. Next thing I remember, I was walking down the street. I'm feeling all right with my balls and soups, yeah. Down along the avenue, some guy was swimming pool, and I heard myself from acapella blues, yeah. It's late in the evening and the girls are on the stools, yeah. When I left to play some lead guitar, I'm underage in funky bar. I set myself, I smoke myself a J.
I love it.
When I come back to the mood, everybody seems to move. I turn my ass on the piano play. It's late in the evening and I threw that room away.
We have invited today to the Sri Lanka Morning Show Rajitha Rupasinghe, the iconic legend of Sri Lankan music, the leader of the band Misty. And it's a pleasure and privilege to have him in the Sri Lanka Morning Show. Welcome to the Sri Lanka Morning Show, Rajitha.
Thank you very much, Sally. It's pleasure. It's my pleasure. Thank you for inviting me.
Talking of the iconic gypsy Sunil Pereira, very sad. I mean, you knew him well. What do you have to say about him as a and his influence with the gypsies and stuff like that?
To begin with, I was a fan of Sunil when I was at the age of 7 or 8 years. The first program I listened to on the radio at that time was the Gluko Rasa Adapaya. And then it's the gypsies who are performing, yeah. And automatically that, I don't know, that struck me. Songs like Snone Mage Sudunone, and those are like toe tappers, and then we automatically, myself and my brother, we were ended up singing as a duet. You know, and then fortunately one of our neighbors, there was this gentleman, there was this auntie, we called her Punjiheva auntie, and one day she came along with Nimal Punjiheva.
Yes.
And then she said, "This is the drummer of gypsies." And I was like, oh, the moon. And since then, my liking towards Sunil Pereira was grown at a tender age. And there onwards, I was a fan of gypsies. And then when I started, I'm going to tell you that, you know, when I started, I had the privilege of meeting him. And I couldn't ask for more.
Yes.
And there onwards, and we shared the same stage.
Oh.
We shared the same stage for nearly a decade.
Really? So you used to sing with the gypsies?
We were sharing the same, what I okay, meant was,
Same concert.
Especially at dinner dancers. By that time, I mean by 2003, 2004, I was like, skyrocketed when it comes to engaged with dinner dancers.
Yes.
Like, we were becoming very popular.
Yes.
And then every time we meet, it was gypsies and Misty. So without any hesitance, like, there were endless nights that with Sunil Pereira.
Jeez.
So my bonding was Sunil Pereira grew. I had to specifically mention this. If someone gave me an helping hand to come up the ladder, you know, one personality was Muhammad Habib while I was in Maldives. But locally, when I started performing at this particular dance, Travel Trade Ball, if I'm not mistaken, that was the first time that we met as musicians. Gypsies on the other side and Misty on the other performing. Yeah. And after my, because they started the dance, and after my second session came around me, gave me a pat on my back. You're going to go a long way.
Jesus.
And our equipment was very ordinary. You know, gypsies, they have the state of the art stuff.
Yes.
and he gave me a hug, and you are going to go places. He recognized my talent. He never had any, like, you know, negativity towards a budding talent. Few days after he called me to his office, he said, my amplifiers, the speakers are, take my set of amplifiers. He gave me a set of he gave me a rack. He said, use it, and when you can update or afford some equipment, come and return it to me.
You become quite emotional when you talk about this.
because he was that close to us. He was probably a godfather
of music. Yeah,
he was very encouraging, because a character, a personality, a legend who I will never forget.
You become very emotional about it, and I can see how much that means, and what a gentleman, what a person. And you know, so many people, not so many, everybody loves Sunil.
Yeah.
But you are, I mean, that's a fan base, but you are a musician yourself, an iconic musician, and this is how you feel about him. Yeah. He must have been just a fantastic human being.
Absolutely.
Yes.
Another relationship, sorry.
That's all right. We were there, I was there with the gypsies when gypsies performed with Savage.
Yep.
As well, you know?
Yeah.
No, I mean, it's great to see. I mean, you're not just an entertainer, you're a human being with so much emotion, and you know, it's great to see such a, you know, we all have emotions, and, but you're really touched by him. And, you know, who are the other musicians that you think have influenced you other than Sunil?
Actually, it was, as I told you, it was, Sunil. You know, the love that we have for music is, you know, when we see our seniors, legendary musicians like Jeffrey, Maxie, you know, all these
guys,
personalities performing, and we get inspired.
Yes.
And for us, it's always good to see, like, as juniors, that, you know, we can get something out of them.
Yes.
And then add it to our capability and to perform.
Saying that, in the reverse now, I mean, I'm sure so many musicians must be inspired by you. And, you know, do you see upcoming performers in the music industry in Sri Lanka going forward?
Yeah, I mean, there is, I mean, from okay, generation changes, and then you get technically, I think we are very advanced now. Technology has, you know, come up with, you know, but lot of talent in music. I mean, if you see lot of younger generation musicians, I mean, they are, I mean, such wonderful talents to see.
That's good to hear.
Yeah, yeah, no, very encouraging.
Coming back to another thing with you, Rajitha, have you written any of your stuff? You do a lot of cover stuff and things.
Yes.
Like that.
I actually, that's something, not that I didn't do, I do, but
people would love to hear that.
People would. I actually sang quite a few, and I collaborated with Sunil Iyer. We did a couple of, even with PL, I recently did an original. I do have some lyrics. It's that I have to put it together and put it out. I
do
actually
it sooner than later.
I regret a lot. actually.
Not doing
yes.
your own thing?
Yes, I regret a lot.
Because you spent a lot of time doing covers and helping the entertainment industry. But personally, I'm sure that must be something that you want to do.
Absolutely, yes. I think before I die, at least I would.
No, you better do it. You're not going to die any
sooner or later.
You're not that old. I mean, the way you move around, Rajitha, you're like a teenager. The way you entertain the music, the way you go around, the way you go about your business, when it comes to the music industry, it's fantastic.
It's a Sunday morning. How I long to be there when Marie, who's waiting for me there. Every lonely city,
la, 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 la.
Where I hang my head,
la, 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 la.
In a Sanford's greeting, is where my baby's at. This is the way to Amarillo. Marie, who waits for me, show me the way to Amarillo. Every night I've been hurting my pillow, crying over Amarillo. Sweet Marie, who waits for me. Everybody sing,
sha la 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 la.